Welcome to this video lecture series on antenna and wave propagation. In this video, we'll discuss the polarization of wave. What is polarization? Polarization is basically the alignment of the component of electric field or magnetic field which are present in the wave. As we know, wave is consist of electric field component plus magnetic field component. In this video, we'll discuss the electric field component, but whatever we discuss is equally applicable to magnetic field component as well. So I said polarization is the orientation of electric field component. So what is orientation? I can align my electric field component in vertical direction or horizontal direction or in any other direction. So if all the orientations are present in the same component, I called it non-polarized wave. But when I restrict all of the component in all other direction and I just want a desired component. So if I want vertical component, I will move just this component and I will restrict all the other components in other directions. So this is basically called polarization. So polarization is the time varying behavior of the electric field strength vector at some fixed point in the space. So I have taken two cases. This is the polarization of the wave in x direction and the polarization of the wave in y direction. We are taking electric field components, so ex wave and ei wave. So this wave is moving in the z direction. So this is the x component. It is moving in the x direction. The maxima are in x direction and the minima are also in the x direction. So this is y component. So the maxima are in y direction and the minima are also in the y direction and it is moving in the z direction. So how can I represent this wave? If I am considering this maxima point to be even. So even is the amplitude of wave in x direction. The maximum point of wave in x direction is even. So I can represent this wave like ex is equal to even cos omega t minus kz because it is moving in the z direction. So this component kz came. So now how can I represent this wave if I am considering the maxima to be e2? So how can I represent this wave? Ey is equal to E2, which is the maximum component in the y direction, omega t minus kz. It is also moving in the positive z direction. So this kz came minus delta. So what is delta? Delta is the phase angle between Ex and Ey. So I hope now you understood how polarization is working and how I am getting my waves in x direction and y direction and how to represent them mathematically. So I have three types of polarization. First is linear polarization, then elliptical polarization, and then circular polarization. I'll discuss all the three types of polarization in detail. So first we'll come to linear polarization. So what happens in linear polarization? Electric field. As I said, we are discussing electric field only. These things are applicable on magnetic field also. So electric field as a function of time remains along a straight line. So if I have electric field, it does not vary. So it is along a straight line only. So it can only has Ex component or Ey component or both Ex and Ey component but are in phase. So these two components can also be present in the same electric field but these are in phase. So what happens if I consider this to be my space? Now how is my linear polarization? If I have only Ex component, so it will look like this. It has plus Ex component and minus Ex component. Similarly, if it has Y component, how I will represent? It would look like this. Now it would have Y component also. So this is plus Ey, this is minus Ey. So what happens in the linear polarization? I have only the linear components, or the electric field as a function of time remains along a straight line only. It does not vary. So I hope now you understood what is linear polarization. Now I'll come to elliptical polarization. Now, what is elliptical polarization? In elliptical polarization, electric field as a function of time traces a ellipse. Now you know the equation of a ellipse, which is ex square upon a square plus ey square upon b square is equal to 1. So this represents my equation of an ellipse. So these electric field components in x and y direction are such that they are forming a ellipse, or they are tracing an ellipse. So E1 cannot be equal to E2 in this case, and the phase difference is always 90 degree. So we can represent this in the form of these graphs. So what happens at time is equal to 0, we have only EY component. We are taking EY component to be bigger in this case. So if I have only EY component at time is equal to 0, now when the time increases, the x component started came at the time t by 8. I have x component as well as y components. Now again it will rotate, and at time t by 4 I will have only x component. Again at time t is equal to 3 t by 8 I have x and y component. Then again at time t by 2 I have only y component. So my wave is moving like this. So this is my right hand polarization, which is also called clockwise polarization. So if in the other case my wave is moving like this, I would call it left hand polarization or anti-clockwise polarization. Now I'll see the third type of polarization, which is circular polarization. So circular polarization is when electric field as a function of time traces a circle. So what happens when I change the time, when I increase the time, electric field should trace a circle. Now I know the equation of circle. Equation of circle is E1 square plus E2 square is equal to R square. Now here E1 is equal to EX and E2 is equal to EY. So EX square plus EY square is equal to R square. So E1 should be equal to E2 for my circle, and the phase angle should be 90 degree. So what happens at time T1 is equal to 0, only I have E1 component. Then time is equal to T by 8, I have both the component. It is again moving like this. So it is also clockwise polarization. At time T1, at time T is equal to T by 4, I have only horizontal component. Again I'll get both the component, and at T by 2 I get only vertical component. So I hope now you know the different types of polarization. Now if I am considering these two be my transmitting and receiving antenna. So if this is my transmitting antenna and this is my receiving antenna. So if these both are linearly polarized antenna, and if this is sending waves to this antenna, this is my transmitting antenna and this is my receiving antenna. So when waves are traveling to this antenna, now these both are equally aligned. So the phase difference is not there. So what happens? All of the waves which are coming from it will received by this antenna. So again in now a different case, what I'll do? I'll change the alignment of my receiving antenna. Now my receiving antenna is perpendicular with respect to my transmitting antenna. So now when the radiations are there, these receiving antenna is not able to capture the radiations from the transmitting antenna. So I can say if I have vertically polarized linear transmitting antenna and vertically polarized linear receiving antenna, and these are not in alignment, these are in perpendicular direction, they would not receive what the transmitting antenna is giving to this receiving antenna. So again now if I change the orientation, So now it will start receiving, but always it is less than the maximum case, which is this, when the alignment is same. So we can measure this by polarization loss factor or polarization matching factor. So if I am considering the electric field of my wave to be EI, now I can represent EI to be EI into AW, where AW is the unit vector of electric field of wave. So similarly, I can represent my electric field of antenna to be EA. So EA represented as EA into A cap, where A cap represents the unit vector of electric field of antenna. So what happens? Polarization loss factor is given by unit vector of electric field of wave multiplied by unit vector of electric field of antenna square. So electric field of wave, electric field of antenna. So now we are giving them in the terms of theta. So if I have these aligned, I'll call it as theta is equal to 0. Now I am changing my alignment, so I am changing my theta. So now I can represent it as cos of psi. So AW dot A is equal to cos of psi. AW dot A square is equal to cos of psi square. So now we are considering three cases, which I explained with the help of pens. So first case, if two unit vectors are perfectly aligned. So when two unit vectors are perfectly aligned, so it was this case. Now what happened? All of the rays came to this antenna and detected by this antenna. So phi p is equal to 0. There is no phase angle between these two. So cos phi p is equal to 1, PLF would be 1. So this is perfectly matched condition. Now again I'll take another condition, if two unit vectors are perpendicular. So this was this condition. Here I was saying no electric field should be detected. So I am saying that the phase angle is 90 degree. That is the phase angle between both of them is 90 degrees. So cos of psi would be 0. So polarization loss factor would be 0. So I am verifying what I was saying. So third condition is if two vectors have angle phi p. So it is the case in between two maxima, that is this and this. So if I am changing the angle in between, so what happens? Cos psi p is less than 1, which implies that polarization loss factor is less than 1. So it is verified that the maximum value of polarization loss factor is 1 and the minimum value is 0. In between, I will get various values between 0 and 1. Now if I want to find out polarization loss factor in decibel, I'll use this formula. That is, polarization loss factor in decibel is equal to 10 log 10 of polarization loss factor. I hope you understand polarization of wave and its different types. I'll stop at this point. In the next video, I'll discuss the various other fundamental parameters of antenna. Stay tuned for those videos, as those would be very beneficial for you. Like my video, subscribe my channel. Thank you.